All right, I'm talking with Eileen in Kansas City, and she is a retired widow. You said again, you're 74, is that right?
Correct.
And you have $650,000 invested, and you have a home that's worth about $275,000, and the $650,000 is currently paying you $1,700 per month.
After taxes.
Okay. Now, let's do some basic.
And
let's just stop.
And my social is about $2,325 a month.
Okay.
So, my Social Security. So, okay. I'm getting about $48,300, and that's plenty to live on. But I don't have the cash for the big items that I can see coming up, mm-hmm. such as the house will need to be painted.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking around $8,000.
Mm-hmm.
I have about 10 windows that are original to the house that mm-hmm. need to be replaced.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to travel.
Mm-hmm.
And my car is a 2002.
Mm-hmm. And the $650,000, you said some of it is in an annuity?
It is. Half of it is in an annuity, and half of it is in an IRA managed funds with Fidelity. Everything's
okay.
with Fidelity.
Okay. Do you have an advisor?
I do.
Okay. And why has your advisor not done, well, let's kind of walk through this for a second, okay? If this money were invested the way I would have it invested if I were in your shoes, I don't do investing for other people, okay? I just teach.
Mm-hmm.
But were it invested in a series of good growth stock mutual funds, I'm 57. Mine's invested 1/4 each in growth and income, aggressive growth, and international. At 74, if you wanted to be a little more conservative, you could substitute the aggressive growth for a balanced. But either way, you should be earning north of 10% on that money. 10% of $650,000 is $65,000 a year. You're currently pulling $18,000. You're getting hosed.
Correct. Wow.
Okay. And if you
so
had 60,
what do I do?
Yeah, if you had $5,000 a month coming in instead of $1,700, a lot of the things you just asked me about would be solved just out of your monthly budget. Am I right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So if you're 650,
well, the way they've got it set up, the money should last me until I'm in my 90s before I ran out of money.
That sucks too. Okay, and here's why. If $650,000 is making 10%, that's $65,000, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Did we touch the $650,000? No. You should be getting $65,000 off of this, and the money lasts forever. You follow me?
Well, I'm not making 10%.
I know. I can tell. And they got this, I'm thinking this annuity must be sitting in a stupid fixed annuity, and you're probably making CD rates on half of your investment portfolio, which is ludicrous. I mean,
well, it's going to be, this October will be, I believe, 5 years, and I can take that money out without any penalties.
That's exactly right, and you're going to. And you're probably going to leave this investment advisor. You need to get somebody that teaches you and shows you what to do. You're smart enough to make these decisions by yourself with some guidance, and that's what an advisor does. They don't do it for you. They don't tell you what to do. They make suggestions and teach you, and you decide what to do. Now, if I were in your shoes, I would start shopping and learning about how I can invest this money so that I have a better monthly income that does not destroy the goose that's laying the golden eggs. The goose is the $650,000. We don't want to touch that, but I want the income that it's producing to be a lot larger without ever touching that and without it absolutely being destroyed by the time you're 90. That's just crazy land.
Okay.
So here's what I want you to do.
I just don't know where to find an advisor that's
okay.
going to help me, that I can trust.
Number one, you're going to trust them only to do one thing, and that's teach you. So the person
right.
I trust with your money is you. I don't want you to hire a babysitter. a full-time nanny for your money. I want you to hire somebody to teach you, and then together, based on their guidance and you understanding what you're going to do, not because Dave Ramsey said or not because an advisor said, but you're going to make the decision because this money was given to you to manage by God, and you're going to make that decision. So the way we put together, we have a network of investment advisors that we recommend. They do not work for me, but I endorse them. And the way we choose them is that they, number one, have to have that heart of a teacher because I want you to learn. Are you okay with that?
Yes.
Okay, good. Because you already know pretty good what you got. I can tell.
Well, I know what I have. My husband, who passed away about 6.5 years ago, was the one that took care of our investments.
Yeah, and it's been on.
And he did invest the money himself and manage it. I don't know enough about the stock market. I mean, I know you have to diversify. I understand all that. But now I'm paying for advisory fees.
Okay. I don't mind paying for advisory fees, but here's what I think happened, okay? I think when he passed away, you guys just kept doing whatever was being done before, and you never questioned. It's kind of been on autopilot, and your call to me, because you can't even paint your house and you're a millionaire. You can't even
That's
go on a trip.
My problem.
And, yeah, you can't even go on a trip and you're a millionaire. And so your call to me is autopilot ain't working. It's time to take the wheel again. You've seen all these autopilot cars are crashing, hadn't you? Yeah, we need to drive our own car. That's what we need to do. And I'm not shaming you. I think you're a very bright lady. So here's what you need to do. Go to DaveRamsey.com, click on SmartVestor. You'll put in a little bit of information. It'll drop down a list of the SmartVestor pros in your area. And Eileen, let me just tell you have a good BS detector. And if you sit down any time with anyone, including if Dave Ramsey endorses them, and you feel like you need to take a shower after you meet with them, then you need a different person. Don't be slimed, okay? Sit down with them and get a good feeling, a sense of trust, but not blind trust. Do they have the heart of a teacher? Do you leave the meeting understanding things that you didn't understand before the meeting? That's called I learned, which means you were in the presence of a teacher. If you don't learn something every time you meet with your investment advisor, something's wrong. You should learn something that you didn't know before. Their job is to teach you to make your own decisions. That's their job. They're an advisor. That's what that means. They give advice. And so click on SmartVestor, and it'll drop down a list of them. Meet with more than one if you want. Take your time. There's nothing on fire here. But, darling, you are not broke. And you shouldn't be living like you're broke. I'm not trying to get you to be a spendthrift and blow all your money. But you need to be enjoying your life a little bit. You guys worked really, really hard all your lives, you and your husband, to get to this point. And he had you set up to be taken care of. And they're starving you to death per month right here. You're getting hosed. So go get some other advice and learn. And I'm going to move some of this money around if I'm you. And I'm going to invest it a little differently so that it's giving me a better rate of return so I can live off of the returns without destroying the principal. Now, what I gave you was an example. I'm not saying you get 10% off of this. But my point was to do some easy math here on the radio and give you an example of what you could do and why you're way off receiving only $18,000 a year of income off of $650,000. Wow. Ouch.